Hello, I'm Chris Barrow with the BBC News. Palestinian officials in Gaza say 7 people from 2 families were killed in an Israeli airstrike that hit a densely packed refugee camp. A 5-month-old baby is said to be the only survivor, found trapped in the rubble next to his dead mother. Paul Adams reports.
The director of the health ministry in Gaza, a member of the militant group Hamas, called the attack a massacre. The group's armed wing said it fired rockets into southern Israel in response. Israeli officials report around 200 rocket launches overnight, with direct hits on apartments in the cities of Ashdod and Beersheba, but no casualties. Today is the day when Palestinians commemorate what they call al-Nakba, the catastrophe, when Israel came into being in 1948 and hundreds of thousands of Palestinians were dispossessed.
Diplomatic efforts to end the fighting are likely to intensify following the arrival of the US envoy Hadi Amr. But Hanan Ashrawi of the Palestinian Liberation Organization says she doesn't think Mr. Amr's involvement will stop the fighting.
Well, I don't think he can do much, frankly speaking, because even at the beginning of the Jerusalem thing last week, Netanyahu clearly said, mind your own business. And Biden waited for a whole week before he sent not even a third, fourth level civil servant. And do you think the Israelis are going to listen? The Americans delayed the Security Council meetings. If they really mean business, then they can at the highest level come out and say, stop the shelling, the killing.
The Chinese President Xi Jinping has congratulated the team behind China's first successful mission to Mars. Calling it an outstanding achievement, Mr. Xi said the scientists had placed China in the advanced ranks of planetary exploration. Earlier, the Tianwen-1 lander touched down on the planet's surface after surviving the treacherous descent by parachute. Helena Wilkinson reports.
The 6-wheeled robot called Zhurong, which means God of Fire, arrived above the planet in February. Since then, it's been surveying the northern part of Mars and taking high-resolution images to pinpoint the safest place to touch down. For its descent, Zhurong used a combination of a protective capsule, a parachute, and a rocket platform. It took 17 minutes to unfold its solar panels and send a signal back to Earth. Scientists will use the rover to spend some time studying the local geology.
A plane flying Australians back from India has arrived at a military airbase in Darwin. They're the first to be repatriated after Australia lifted its controversial ban on travel from India because of its devastating coronavirus surge. The flight carried only 80 people. 70 others were not allowed to board because they tested positive for COVID or had been identified as close contacts. This is the latest world news from the BBC. China has banned attempts to climb Mount Everest from its Tibetan site because of concerns that climbers might become infected with coronavirus. COVID infections have spiraled in Nepal, which shares the mountaintop. Our Asia-Pacific editor, Michael Bristow, reports.
Earlier this week, China decided to introduce a quarantine line at the very peak of Mount Everest to prevent its climbers mingling with those coming from the Nepalese side and becoming infected. It came after a number of climbers arriving through Nepal contracted COVID. Many thought the plan was unworkable, considering the very top of Everest is not much larger than a tabletop. Now China has abandoned that plan altogether. Surging coronavirus cases in Nepal have convinced Beijing to cancel all attempts up the world's highest mountain through Tibet.
Chinese media say 2 tornadoes have struck central and eastern China, killing at least 12 people and injuring more than 400. 8 died in the central city of Wuhan, where violent winds destroyed at least 27 houses. Another tornado killed 4 people in the town of Shenji in Jiangsu province. Emergency teams are being deployed to India's western coastal states as they prepare for the arrival of the first named cyclone of the year. Cyclone Tauktae is already causing heavy rainfall, raising concerns about floods and landslides. Meteorologists fear it may intensify and develop into a severe storm as it reaches land. Coastal evacuations have begun in some low-lying areas. People in Chile will be voting later today to elect 150 delegates to rewrite the constitution, which dates back to the dictatorship of General Augusto Pinochet in 1980. Constitutional change was a key demand of mass protests against inequality that shook Chile in 2019. The new system demands equal representation of men and women and has 17 dedicated seats for Chile's indigenous groups. BBC News.
from Beletín Radio Nacional de España at 9:59 a.m. today.
Radio Nacional de España. Servicios informativos.
Buenos días. Intensos movimientos entre comunidades en el primer fin de semana completo sin muchas de las restricciones que amparaba el estado de alarma. Estos movimientos se notan sobre todo en regiones costeras donde la subida de las temperaturas anima también a acudir a las playas. Es el caso, por ejemplo, de la Comunidad Valenciana. En la de la Malvarrosa está Miguel Ángel Ors. Miguel Ángel, buenos días.
Buenos días. A esta hora de la mañana, la playa de la Malvarrosa de Valencia se va llenando de visitantes, gente que viene buscando disfrutar de la tranquilidad de la playa a esta hora de la mañana, del sol, del mar, pero también del aire libre en un fin de semana con temperaturas casi estivales. Luce el sol, tenemos alguna nube en el cielo de Valencia, pero también la gente busca salir a la calle, vivir un poco la tarde y la noche. Algunos llegaban hace unas horas y tienen muy claro lo que buscan.
Venimos toda la familia, mis hijas, mi marido, a pasar el día aquí a la playa.
Hemos venido a pasar el fin de semana, nos vamos el domingo.
Dar una vueltecita por el centro de Valencia y por las artes. Nos gusta mucho venir y disfrutar de las playas y estar tranquilas.
Hombre, playa, playa.
Desde la patronal hostelera ve que cifran una ocupación de entre el 60 y el 70%. Los ayuntamientos de los municipios costeros han preparado dispositivos para recibir miles de turistas y poder garantizar el cumplimiento de las normas anti-COVID. En Alicante, por ejemplo, la Policía Nacional dobla los efectivos desplegando más de 400 agentes para evitar aglomeraciones. Los puntos que hay que vigilar son las zonas de ocio, playa y el cumplimiento, sobre todo, del toque de queda. Las autoridades locales piden a los vecinos un nuevo esfuerzo y a los visitantes corresponsabilidad. El objetivo es garantizar la seguridad de todos.
Gracias. Sigue siendo necesario mantener todas las medidas de seguridad. De hecho, en Barcelona esta pasada noche la Guardia Urbana ha desalojado a más de 7.000 personas en diversos espacios de la ciudad. Precisamente en Cataluña los últimos datos confirman la tendencia positiva que se vive en el conjunto de España. Allí caen los nuevos contagios, se mantienen los ingresados en las UCIs y solo se registró en los hospitales catalanes un fallecimiento frente a los 6 del día anterior. Tampoco hay fallecidos hoy en Aragón, donde los nuevos casos caen de 236 a 198. Todo en buena parte debido a la vacunación. 7 millones de personas, casi un 15% de la población, han recibido ya la pauta completa. Aumentan a 139 los civiles muertos en Gaza tras 6 días de enfrentamientos entre el ejército de Israel y las milicias palestinas. Ambulancias egipcias han entrado a la franja para trasladar a los heridos por el último ataque del ejército de Israel. Beatriz Gajate.
Una decena de ambulancias ha entrado en la franja de Gaza para que los heridos sean tratados en hospitales egipcios. Y es que el enclave palestino recibió más de 50 bombardeos en 40 minutos desde tierra y aire. Uno de los ataques impactaba contra una casa de un campo de refugiados, matando a 8 niños y 2 mujeres, miembros de la misma familia. Como dice uno de los refugiados, nadie está seguro en Gaza.
Es como el infierno, no podemos salir a la calle porque es muy peligroso, no sabemos dónde caerá el siguiente misil y nadie está a salvo, ni siquiera en sus hogares, porque están bombardeando las casas de civiles.
Tras 6 días consecutivos de enfrentamientos, 139 palestinos, de ellos 40 niños han fallecido y 1 millar de heridos. En Israel son 9 los fallecidos.
De nuevo en España, preocupación en torno a los datos sobre el aumento de la temperatura media. Desde la época industrial, hablamos del año 1850, la temperatura se ha incrementado en 1,7 grados, pero de ese aumento 1,3 corresponden tan solo a los últimos 60 años. El Congreso aprobaba esta semana la primera ley contra el cambio climático, una ley que para algunas organizaciones ecologistas llega tarde, otros países como Reino Unido tienen una ley similar desde hace 13 años. En el programa Parlamento de Radio 5, Juan López Duralde, presidente de la Comisión Parlamentaria para la Transición Ecológica, culpa de ese retraso las ideas negacionistas que a día de hoy, dice, siguen influyendo.
Hablamos de un tema complejo y hablamos de un tema que efectivamente tiene consecuencias que nos viene mal. Es decir, nos viene mal que el cambio climático exista y nos viene mejor escuchar a quien dice que eso es una milonga, claro, porque así no tienes que hacer nada, ¿no?
Y una cosa más, la Guardia Civil ha tenido en Almería 8 personas en el transcurso de 2 operaciones contra el tráfico de hachís. Los arrestados trataban de introducir la droga hasta casi 4 toneladas en las playas de Agua Dulce y de Roquetas de Mar. Es todo. Sigan informados en esta sintonía, la de Radio Nacional de España y también en rtv.es.
Radio Nacional de España.
Saturday, May the 15th, and this is your morning briefing from The Economist. Coming up, American stores go mask-free, and fighting around Israel broadens. First, the week in brief. Walmart and Costco joined a growing list of big American retailers that will no longer require shoppers to wear masks, provided they have been vaccinated against COVID-19. Meanwhile, Britain's government issued a warning about a variant of the virus first detected in India, B.1.617, now spreading rapidly in other countries. It may slow the country's relief from restrictions. Fighting within and around Israel broadened, Jewish and Arab civilians clashed in its cities, Israeli security forces killed at least 11 Palestinians in the West Bank, and new protests ignited at the borders with Jordan and Lebanon. The Israel Defense Forces continued pounding the Gaza Strip with artillery, while Hamas launched rockets back. Their five-day exchange has so far killed more than 132 Palestinians in Gaza and 8 people in Israel. Republicans in America's House of Representatives elected Elise Stefanik, a congresswoman from New York who is a staunch supporter of Donald Trump, as conference chair, a powerful leadership position. Ms. Stefanik replaces Liz Cheney, who was ousted from the role after criticizing the former president for his, quote, big lie that last year's presidential election result was fraudulent. Edwin Poots was elected leader of the Democratic Unionist Party in Northern Ireland, succeeding Arlene Foster after she lost a confidence vote last month. He is likely to succeed her as Northern Ireland's first minister. At present, the agriculture minister, he has promised to intensify the party's opposition to the contentious Northern Ireland Protocol that introduces checks on goods crossing the Irish Sea. Britain's Serious Fraud Office launched an investigation into, quote, suspected fraud, fraudulent trading and money laundering at GFG Alliance, a steel and mining conglomerate run by Sanjeev Gupta that employs around 35,000 people. GFG has been struggling to raise funds since its main financier, Greensill Capital, collapsed in March. FireEye, a cybersecurity firm, claimed that DarkSide, a criminal group, has told other hackers that it plans to close. DarkSide is thought to be behind ransomware attacks that recently shut down the Colonial Pipeline, America's biggest fuel conduit, for 5 days, and stole data from a division of Toshiba, a Japanese electronics firm. Sales at DoorDash, which has bitten off the largest chunk of America's food delivery market, tripled in the first 3 months of the year compared with the same period in 2020. However, the company did not narrow its losses as much as analysts had expected, illustrating the difficulty of turning strong demand from lockdown diners into profits. And fact of the day. Last month, oil prices in America were 272% higher than a year earlier. Nothing to do with the Colonial Pipeline.
That's it from The Economist Morning Briefing, available every weekday and on Saturdays. You can hear interviews and analysis from our journalists, including our current affairs podcast, The Intelligence, by asking your smart speaker to play the latest Economist radio podcast. To enjoy the full morning briefing as well as the rest of our journalism, including each week's full edition in audio, please consider taking out a subscription. To get the best introductory offer wherever you are around the world, just go to economist.com/briefing offer. Digital subscribers to The Economist should log in at briefing.economist.com for access to the full Economist morning briefing.
Good.